may have heard that we're changing from our paper PCR to an electronic PCR solution. The ePCR solution consists of the device and software application that you see here. The ePCR project team, in consultation with the paramedic working group, chose the Panasonic H2 Toughbook. It was chosen for a variety of reasons. Specifically, because it's designed for healthcare, it has an operating temperature range of minus 30 to plus 60 degrees C. Another reason that this device was chosen was the fact that you can read the screen even in bright sunlight. On the bottom is located a barcode reader for reading the new driver's licenses. On the back is a built-in camera. And it's lightweight, only 3.5 pounds, even with both batteries installed here and here. These batteries are considered hot swappable, which means that you can remove a depleted battery and replace it with a fresh one without losing any of your previously entered information. It has a touch screen, which allows input from a finger, a gloved hand, or this stylus. It is ergonomically designed. What do I mean by that? Well, it has a strap on the back here, which is designed for comfort and ease of use. Lastly, there is a cleaning reminder to aid in infection control. The iMedic ePCR from Interdev Technologies in Ontario was chosen as our new ePCR. Some of the benefits are, our dispatch information is now automatically entered into our form as it comes in. Medications can be chosen from a drop-down list rather than having to write them in manually. iMedic also allows for a number of inputs, either from an on-screen keyboard, handwriting recognition, a stylus, or from a gloved finger. There is also a checker, which will advise you if you've left out any important fields on your form. Now, when the ePCR is read by healthcare professionals in the hospital, they will see a professionally spell-checked form with no handwriting to interpret from a rain-splattered form. And best of all, no more scanning when you get back to the station. Another convenience is that you're able to access treatment guidelines online anytime at your convenience. This application is flexible as well and allows for us to keep pace with patient care improvements as we move forward. The quick answer is continuum of healthcare or health authority information exchange. What do I mean by that? Well, think of an inter-hospital transfer of a critically ill patient. As a paramedic, you input your care for that patient on your ePCR. Now it can be easily transferred to the receiving hospital care staff. What does this mean for the patient? Well, it improves in patient safety as well as patient outcomes. Patients can also benefit now from research initiatives as the data is easily available, allowing for evidence-based improvements to patient care. Less typing. NETCAD data and patient information from care cards and driver's licenses will now automatically be filled into the form quickly and accurately. Defibrillator data can now be uploaded at any time through the H2 device. Superintendents, district supervisors, and unit chiefs can now run reports to provide feedback for paramedics. The same reports can contribute to evidence-based research to support paramedics' ambitions for a wider scope of practice. Easy access to reports will provide operations with evidence of what is actually happening on the ground to improve decision-making. This evidence can be used to improve the effectiveness of the RAP or the resource allocation plan. Reports can also be used to inform continuing education and training priorities. Looking for more information? Please look for us on the BCAS intranet site under the Projects heading and check out our FAQs there. If you still need a question answered, please feel free to email us at epcr.solution@gov.bc.ca. Thank you for listening and drive safely out there.